Hello everyone, welcome back. Hope you're having a wonderful and relaxing Sunday. In this video, I would like to discuss the future of Verdansk. If you've been following along for the past couple of weeks, you may have noticed that I've given my opinion on what I personally think is going to happen at the end of the Outbreak event. But since I've originally made that video talking about that theory, some new images have leaked directly from the game code, and based off of what we're seeing, woo! I might have missed the mark by a lot. There's a lot going on here, and we're going to discuss that today. Like I've said in previous videos, don't believe everything you hear. Take it with a grain of salt. Obviously, we're just going to be having a discussion here today, and unfortunately, I'm not going to be able to show you the images just in case they are actually real. I don't feel like getting a copyright strike anytime soon. If you'd like to see the images for yourself, visit the link in the description below. It will take you directly to those images at The Ghost of Hope over on Twitter. Now, this particular account is a secondary data mining account that has proven to be truthful in many of the things that it has discovered and, of course, posted here. It's also had multiple videos and photos removed by Activision, so I wouldn't be shocked if these images turn out to be real. But the tweet itself says, "I'm posting these here because I believe this is what Verdansk will look like after March 11th. The left one was in the files. The one on the right is overlapping to compare. This has been in the files for months, going unnoticed. Oddly enough, that is lava slash magma." In a follow-up tweet to this, they simply say, "Someone sent me this." In the image that was posted, it would seem to be references to the magma that was just talked about in the previous tweet, and they look like they're in the form of an audio file. Let's discuss the image, and I know it's going to be a little difficult to imagine, but if you'd like to follow along with the image itself, once again, it will be linked in the description below. Now, the image, at first glance, you would look at it and say, well, this just looks like a big splotchy red thing. Maybe this is a texture that belongs on a character's model. Maybe this was going to be an asset for a special ability, or maybe it was going to be an asset on a map. We don't entirely know. But in this particular tweet, which is once again linked in the description below, they overlapped it with the map of Verdansk, and it kind of makes sense. There's been a rumor going around for the past couple of days that when the nukes go off, the airport, the superstore, the TV station, storage town, the hospital, downtown or part of downtown will be destroyed. The military base will no longer be there. The dam will be destroyed. Pretty much a huge chunk of the map being destroyed in some way, shape, or form. And with this overlap and the image itself, it shows basically those general areas, mostly in what I would assume is a crater. It kind of does look like a map of lava, almost similar to what we saw with Transit, which kind of is weird to say that, but I'm trying to think about it from the perspective of actual gameplay. How would it work trying to navigate around a crater of lava? I don't know if you'd be able to jump from one place to another, or if there'd be floating debris that you're able to walk across, or if you wouldn't be able to access that area at all. In my personal opinion, I think that if there was to be an event like this that sends huge nukes into the area, and then for some reason the remainder of the map is surrounded by magma and lava, maybe it would be similar to what we saw with the Black Ops Cold War reveal event in Warzone, where you would be teleported in the second half, and then you'd have no weapons or anything, and you would need to run to a specific location to exfil. I could actually see that happening. Do you remember when we all had to run to the stadium and all you had to do was just make your way there, and by the time the countdown timer ended, it would play the trailer? Something like that could technically happen. Taking an exfil chopper to get out, I guess, it kind of makes sense. You could get into a bunker to survive, potentially, I suppose. And then you could exit said bunker, get to the exfil chopper, be extracted, and then taken to the new experience, which we think is the Ural Mountains. It was said by another rumor, now they're kind of compounding, they're stacking on each other. Another rumor mentioned that the Black Ops Cold War experience would be ushered into Warzone at the beginning of April. And I guess that kind of would make sense considering this particular event is going to be ending on March 11th. So maybe from March 11th to the beginning or the end of April, we'll be dealing with this new magmified Verdansk. But then again, I don't know why they would do a complete map overhaul and then only have it available for, you know, like a month and a half before it goes away. If they were going to do something like that, you would think they would have done this a month ago and at least gave us 2 or 3 months with this new map with ever-changing things that could happen. I'm also trying to fight internally and make heads or tails of the situation that is lava. Like, where would the lava originate from? Where would it even have come from? Especially now knowing that in the follow-up tweet, there was apparently audio files referencing the magma. That also has me very, very confused. But in a way, this kind of makes sense. Let's say, for example, the exfil does happen. We do leave the area because there is a bunch of lava, and we can't fight in that particular area for the time being. If we leave and head to the Ural Mountains for a few months and we start playing in that Black Ops Cold War experience, we could always make a return to Verdansk after the lava's cooled down, if that's even a thing that could potentially happen. We would then be playing on a newly developed Verdansk, something that's been completely wiped out and destroyed. Or potentially, people could have come back and started rebuilding. And if that was the case, then we could be playing on a new experience altogether. Familiar locations, but new in general. Something that we actually saw pretty frequently with the Blackout experience in BO4. We saw areas that were getting developed, received new updates and new locations, but even though it was familiar, there was still new to it. And I think if a bunch of stuff gets wiped out by a nuke in general, that gives total creative liberty to the team that's rebuilding the map. They could rearrange buildings, they could take map locations out completely, they could add new locations, they could rebuild the airport differently, they could do pretty much anything they want to do at that point. And if we're over fighting the outbreak or something else in the Ural Mountains while all this is happening, it will then give the team an opportunity to integrate that map once again back into the game in a future season, or potentially hold off all the way until the next Call of Duty game and then fold it in there. That's the problem when it comes to a game as a live service. It needs to be ever-changing. And with Warzone, they haven't really done as much as they did with Blackout in the first year. In fact, I think there wasn't much done at all in the sense of changing up the map. Sure, we've got new points of interest. We have a train that kind of goes around. We have new areas that have doors and new interior locations. But I think people are waiting for that big change. The nuke event rumor started last year, for goodness sakes. It's been a whole year, a 1 year anniversary on that, if you will. But anyway, let me know what y'all think about this down below in the comment section. I still don't really understand where this lava or magma is going to come from. Maybe the nuke just ends up hitting the earth so bad that it starts seeping from the core. I have no freaking clue. I'm trying to figure out how that would work. Leave your thoughts in the comment section below. If you guys enjoyed this video today, drop a like on it. Subscribe for more awesome videos coming each and every day. And if you haven't yet, please do not forget to ring that bell icon next to the subscribe button. That way YouTube will notify you every single time my videos go live. Alrighty, folks, I will catch you on the next one. Peace.